as we stand, let us pray for a closer union with Christ in his suffering and in his glory. Almighty and everlasting God, who in your tender love towards the human race sent your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, to take upon him our flesh and to suffer death upon the cross, grant that we may follow the example of his patience and humility, and also be made partakers of his resurrection, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for our readings from the Bible.
The first reading is taken from Isaiah, chapter 50, reading from verses 4 to 9a. The sovereign Lord has given me a well-instructed tongue to know the word that sustains the weary. He wakens me morning by morning, wakens my ear to listen like one being instructed. The sovereign Lord has opened my ears. I have not been rebellious, I have not turned away. I offered my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who pulled out my beard. I did not hide my face from mocking and spitting. Because the sovereign Lord helps me, I will not be disgraced. Therefore have I set my face like flint, and I know I will not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who then will bring charges against me? Let us face each other. Who is my accuser? Let him confront me. It is the sovereign Lord who helps me. Who will condemn me? This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The second reading is from Philippians chapter 2, verses 5 to 11. Have this mind among yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Our gospel hymn this morning, Ride On, Ride On in Majesty. If you're able, please stand as we sing together.
Ride on. on, ride on in majesty. Hark, all the
At Bethphage and Bethany, near the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately, as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say this, 'The Lord needs it, and will send it back here immediately.'" They then went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, "What are you doing untying the colt?" They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." Then he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, O Christ. Thank you, Hazel. And so, Lord, take my words and speak through them. Take our thoughts and think through them. Take our hearts and lives and set them on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. Do please have a seat. What did you expect would happen? What would you expect? You see, whatever situation we find ourselves in, we go into them with a set of expectations of what we think might happen. Certainly, if you were at the football yesterday, expectations of winning titles and promotion and things like that. And I'm told that there was, I haven't seen it, but I'm told there was at the end of the game a bit of a pitch invasion went on. What would you expect? There's the scene at the beginning of Series 1, Episode 1 of that great TV programme, The Vicar of Dibley, where Geraldine, in the midst of a stormy night, is arriving at David Horton's house as the parishioners there are ready to meet their new vicar. And there is outrage palpable, shock, disappointment, when said new vicar is a woman. As words are being forced to be eaten very quickly. As letters to the bishop are prepared at an emergency council meeting. Until somebody says, surely we should at least give her a Sunday. Obviously, expectation had not quite met with reality. What did they expect would happen when the Messiah would arrive? Of course, the expectation of the time was some big warrior king who'd come in, duff up a few enemies, and make everything the way that just they liked it, that God's people would shine brightly throughout the world, Israel would be safe, the Romans would have been pushed out, and everything will be well. And as we know, expectation and reality was somewhat different. The colt, a symbol not of a warring king, but of somebody who comes in peace. Not what was expected. The crowd of people who've gathered, who've taken their coats off to put on the colt, who've strewn the road with leafy branches, the handmade red carpet, if you like. Not what you would have expected. And certainly as the week of following events would work itself out, not the conclusion that anybody would have expected either. The triumphant entry, the sham trial, the crucifixion, and the resurrection. Not what people would have expected. Perhaps the lesson for all of us, myself included, is that when we expect God to do something in a particular way, expect the unexpected. Because when God gets involved, stuff tends to happen. But not necessarily the things that we expect. Not necessarily the way that we expect them to happen. But nonetheless, God's plan and his purpose begin to work themselves out. Amen. So, excuse me, if you wish, please stand with me as we affirm our faith in the God of the unexpected, in the words of the Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. In peace, let us sit or kneel to pray.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you promised through your Son, Jesus Christ, to hear us when we pray in faith. On this Palm Sunday, as he enters Jerusalem on a donkey, let us, like the crowds, acclaim Christ as righteous, victorious, and yet lowly. Holy Week sees the initial support of the crowds and then their rejection of Christ before his crucifixion and triumph. Challenge our expectations, Lord. Help us to be true and consistent in our faith and worship you. And we ask for your forgiveness when we fail. We pray for your church and for all Christian leaders and followers. We pray for our bishops, Libby and Malcolm, and our diocese. In our parish, we pray for our clergy, Andy and Dave, our church warden, the PCC, and those who contribute towards the running of our churches. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for Charles, our king, and his family. We pray for wisdom and compassion to our leaders and all in authority. We pray that this and every nation may be guided by you in the ways of justice and of peace. We pray for those suffering from the consequences of conflict in the Ukraine and Russia, in the Gaza Strip and Israel, in Sudan and the Yemen. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we pray for the inhabitants of our parish of Eckington with Ridgeway, for those who live and work here. In our contacts with others in our lives, let these be opportunities to share your message of forgiveness and life after death. We pray for those travelling at this time, for those choosing to journey on holiday, and for those who journey to escape persecution and violence. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those who are sick, for those in hospital or at home, for rich or for poor, who are impacted just the same. We pray for their families and friends. We pray for those who care for them throughout the health service and care and support services. Reach out to those who are struggling in their lives through addictions and dependencies, that however dark it may seem, you are always there to listen to them and that they may see that light. We pray for those who are grieving, that there is comfort in your resurrection, and may your living word bring comfort and healing to all those in need. Lord, in your mercy, we give thanks to all those who have died in the faith of Christ, and we rejoice with them and all your saints, trusting in the promise of your word fulfilled. Make our voices one with all your people on heaven and on earth. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Once we were far off, but now in union with Christ Jesus, we have been brought near through the shedding of Christ's blood, for he is our peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
We share with one another a sign of peace. Peace, 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 peace. Peace at home. Peace, 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 peace. Peace, maestro. Peace, 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 peace. Our offertory hymn this morning, O Sacred Head Surrounded. Once again, if you're able, please stand as we sing. Jesus, true vine and bread of life, ever giving yourself that the world might live, let us share your death and passion. Make us perfect in your love. Amen. The Lord is here. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For as the time of his passion and resurrection draws near, the whole world is called to acknowledge his hidden majesty. The power of the life-giving cross reveals the judgment that has come upon the world and the triumph of Christ crucified. He is the victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever, our advocate in heaven to plead our cause, exalting us there to join with angels and archangels forever praising you and singing. We thank you, loving Father, because you sent Jesus, your Son. He gave his life for us on the cross and shows us the way to live. Send your Holy Spirit that these gifts of bread and wine may be for us Christ's body and his blood. On the night before he died, when darkness had fallen, Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, and shared it with his disciples. "This is my body," he said, "given for you. Do this to remember me." After they had eaten, he took the cup, gave thanks, and shared wine with his disciples. "This is my blood," he said, "poured out for you and for all people to save them from their sins. Do this to remember me." Great is the mystery of faith. Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate his love, his death, his risen life. As you feed us with these gifts, send your Holy Spirit and change us more and more to be like Jesus, our Saviour. Help us to love one another and to work together for that day when the whole world is fed, suffering is ended, and all creation is gathered in your loving arms. With all your saints, we give you glory through Jesus Christ, in the strength of the Spirit, forever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we sit or kneel to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. a moment or two, if you wish to receive the bread and wine of communion, do please make your way up to the altar rail behind me. Please don't trip over the palm branches on the way. If you'd rather receive a prayer of blessing, that's great. Please work your way up to the altar rail, but just keep your hands by your sides and I'll know what your wishes are. If you'd rather have a few moments of quiet with God in your pew, that's absolutely fine as well. And so draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith and with thanksgiving. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you humbled yourself in taking the form of a servant, and in obedience died on the cross for our salvation. Give us the mind to follow you, and to proclaim you as Lord and King, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Faithful God, may we who share this banquet glory in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, our salvation, life, and hope, who reigns as Lord now and forever. Amen. We come now to the notices. With this week being Holy Week, there are quite a few, so I'm going to try and rattle through these quick. Tuesday morning, 10 till 12, tea, coffee, cake. That carries on as usual, I'm assuming. Yeah. And then at 7:30, there is the Eckington singers will be bringing us the a sort of choral version of the Stations of the Cross. So do please come along and support that. That's a freebie. There will be a retiring collection, and there's usually some pretty good refreshments afterwards as well. Wednesday evening, 7 o'clock for 7:15-ish. It's the latest of our Lent course stroke Bible study stroke confirmation course. It's communion part two this week if you're interested, and you're all very welcome to come along for that. Maundy Thursday, there's 7:30, there will be a Maundy Thursday service here. Good Friday, 11 o'clock service as usual in the centre of town. You're welcome to meet us here at 10:30 to walk down with the cross, or meet us straight in the centre of town, whichever's good for you. And then there's the last hour at the cross at 2 o'clock here as well. And then Easter Day itself, 9:30 Easter Communion here, or 11 o'clock Easter Communion at Ridgeway. Whilst we're talking Easter Sunday, can I just draw your attention to the little flyer about helping to decorate the church? I'm sure you can all read, so I'll not insult your intelligence. There is that. There is also a thank you from Mary and Eleanor. For those who attended Mary's coffee morning a couple of weeks ago now, isn't it? £167 was raised. And where's that going? £167 for Sheffield Children's Hospital. So, absolutely. Thank you very much to everybody who supported Eleanor and Mary in that. We're going to draw the 100 Club after the service for this month today. There's also a last chance, if you have a chat with Ali, to get your raffle tickets for the Easter eggs. That will get drawn after the service on Easter Day itself, and you might be going home with some chocolatey goodness. Are there any other notices we need to share? Nope. Fantastic. In which case, our final hymn, as we look towards the events of Holy Week, When I Survey the Wondrous Cross. Once again, if you're able, please stand as we sing.
I'm not afraid.
May the Father, who so loved the world that he gave his only Son, bring you by faith to his eternal life. Amen. May Christ, who accepted the cup of sacrifice in obedience to the Father's will, keep you steadfast as you walk with him in the way of the cross. Amen. May the Spirit, who strengthens us to suffer with Christ, that we may share his glory, set your minds on life and peace. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you, now and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.